Powerlifting consists of three main lifts: the squat, the bench press, and the deadlift. Each lifter, in various weight categories, gets three attempts at each lift. To be a good lift, each lifter has to meet certain criteria, which three referees around the lifter will determine. At the end of the competition, awards are presented to the lifters in each weight category with the highest squat, bench press, deadlift, and highest combined total. A lifter's overall total is determined by the sum of their best lifts, and the individual with the highest total is considered the all-round strongest lifter in their category.
And welcome to day four of the European Junior and Sub Junior Powerlifting Championships here in Orosháza, Hungary. We get a beautiful sunny day outside. We are here in the hall for the last two women's classes. We will have the under 84 kilo class and the 84 plus kilo class. A total of two lifters over the two classes. So not a big field. It shouldn't take too long to get through this today, but because we won't be running back-to-back flights, there will be 20-minute breaks between the squat and the bench press, and again between the bench press and the deadlift. We're certainly going to see a Hungarian home gold medal today, barring disasters, because the 84 plus class is being contested by two Hungarian lifters, Kotelez and Lovas, and it should be a great battle between the two of them. The predictions based on their opening attempts in all three lifts is only putting 10 kilos between them for the gold medal. So we look forward to seeing the two Hungarians battle it out for gold. And in the under 84 kilo class, well, the predictions have the top two only 5 kilos apart. That's Hoas, the Norwegian, and Kasperska, the Polish lifter. So we've not got a big field, but we're looking forward to battles in both lifts. I've just been joined by Ralph Farquharson. Don't know if you want to say a few words, Ralph. We're just waiting for the officials for this session to enter the platform.
Yeah,
welcome.
Good morning to you all, and look forward to a short morning, but should be some good lifting. So hope you've been enjoying it, and we again try to keep you up to date and give you a running commentary on what's happening in the hall.
And hopefully it won't be as controversial as last night, and we won't be making the comments we were about any of the lifters. That was some class last night, wasn't it, in the 84s, Ralph, in the 83s?
Yes, it was.
But here we are now welcoming the officials onto the platform. I'll tell you who they are as they're called forward. That's Chief Referee. And that's Tony Ingebrigtsen from Norway. And Jiri Hofanek from the Czech Republic is the third referee. The jury for this session is Janos Bayan from Hungary. Imre Feher from Hungary. And Werner Hefner from Germany. And the technical controller for this session is Anna Dietler from Hungary. And the referees are just going to take their positions. And the clock is ticking down to 1 minute 40 seconds. That's how long we've got before lifting commences. Just to recap, we have 4 lifters contesting the under 84 kilo class. 2 Hungarians, Ralph, in the 84 plus, so definitely a home gold medal today. Very close battle between the two of them. They're predicted, based on openers, to be only 10 kilos apart. So that should be a fascinating battle as the session develops.
Yes, should be. So, okay. Almost ready to go.
1 minute and counting. 1 minute. Just to let you know that the second session tonight will start at 5 p.m. local time. And that will be the junior men in the 93 and 105 kilo class. And then we finish off on Saturday at 12 noon with the big guys, the 120 and the 120 plus group. So that's what we've got coming up.
That should be a good session on Saturday morning.
Yes, it certainly should.
And also tonight.
And as we've been doing our best for the rest of the week, we'll try and talk you through all the lifts, tell you who the lifters are, what they're attempting, where it's going to place them in the competition, and perhaps now and again what we think of the choice of weights. But hopefully that won't be necessary. The first lifter up is going to be Eva Nemeth from Hungary. She's a 21-year-old student with a squat PB of 140 kilos. She looks to be opening quite conservatively at 110 kilos.
I know Eva quite well. She was my interpreter when I was here for inspections.
Oh, excellent. Well, you'll be wishing her well.
Certainly
I'm sure
will.
We all do. She's predicted for fourth place.
It's the first competition, international. So,
it'll be great experience for her.
Yes.
And here she goes, Nemeth from Hungary, opening the day's lifting with a squat of 110 kilos. Oh, that's nice and deep.
It's a good opener for her. That should get rid of the nerves, I hope.
It certainly should. Next up, we go to the one of the Hungarians in the over 84 kilo class. This is Maria Kotelesz. She's a 23-year-old student with a squat PB of 200 kilos. predicted to win by 10 kilos, but predictions don't always come true. Opening slightly lower than her competitor, who will probably be next up at 175, although it looks like it may be Deschamps. And it looks like the bar is ready for Maria Cotelej, Hungary, 170 kilos. And as we've said every other day, Ralph, it'd be lovely to see all the lifters get the first squat in, settle the nerves, and then go on to progress in the competition before that. Often the hardest lift of the competition is the first squat. Get that out of the way and the lifter can begin to relax and perform a little bit. But here she goes, 170 kilos. That looks smooth and comfortable. Oh, she gets one in depth.
Yeah, and again, say in depth, yes, red, yeah. Red light.
But 2-1 is good. Now we go back to the 84 kilo class. This is the Belgian lifter, Nadege Deschamps, 18-year-old student. She's got a PB of 200 kilos, and she's opening at 175. And here comes Nadege Deschamps to attempt 175 kilos. Based on personal bests, all these lifters seem to be opening quite conservatively, Ralph, which we've been saying all week is a very, very sensible approach, particularly in a championship like this. Now, was that deep enough?
Not sure.
See what the referees say. Two said yes, one said no. So that's a good lift for Deschamps, and she's off the mark as well. We move back to the 84 plus kilo category. This is the second Hungarian lifter, and this is Monika Lovas, and she is opening at 175 kilos. Lovas is going to be in the battle with Cotelej all afternoon, not only for the gold and silver overall, but for the gold and silver in each of the individual disciplines. For those of you joining us for the first time, medals are awarded in each of the individual lifts as well as for the total. Here goes Lovas. That looks good. Very strong on the way up. Three white lights. And now we move back to the 84 kilo class for the last two lifters. Next up is the Norwegian, Katrin Hoash. And the speaker is pronouncing her Hirsch, so I think that's what I'll do for the rest of the day as well. Katrin Hirsch, Norway, 23-year-old student with a PB of 195, and she's coming in 190. Well, perhaps slightly nearer limit than the other girls we've seen so far, but we've seen a lot of lifters through the week come in close to what was their PB and blast the first one. So hopefully Hirsch from Norway can do the same thing.
She got some fun in the room.
And she's got a Norwegian referee in the sidelines, Tony Ingebrigtsen. Experienced referee who will obviously referee the lift and not the lifter, but I'm sure she'd be willing her well nonetheless. So here we go with Hirsch from Norway with her opener, 190 kilos.
That looks good.
That looks good. Three white lights. And the last lifter of the first round, is going to be the Polish lifter Kasperska. Ralph, no Russians, no Ukrainians.
No, we train all week and I don't seem to.
They've been dominating most of the classes.
I don't think they intend to send them out until they're both ready to take the classes, I think. So maybe next year, we'll see.
Could give someone else a chance. So this is Kasperska from Poland, Kamila Kasperska. She has a best of 215 kilos. No, sorry, she's opening at 215 kilos. And this to take a very big lead after just one round in the under 84 kilo class. Weighing in at 78.4 kilos, well under the weight limit for the class. And that's three white lights all day long. And if we have a quick look at the scoreboard at the end of the first round, we can see that in the under 84 kilo class, Kasperska from Poland leads from Hirsch of Norway, with Deschamps of Belgium quite close behind. And in the 84 plus class, the two Hungarians battling it out, Lovas 5 kilos ahead of Kotelej. And we move into the second round lifts. And first up will be your translator, Ralph.
Yep.
Eva Nemeth from Hungary. She's put an extra 10 kilos on the bar. First ever international competition here for the experience, and what an experience she's going to get lifting in front of her home crowd in the European Junior Championships.
She told me all her families are watching and so giving a shout. Somebody, a mum and dad is in the hall, I think. So.
Well, hello to Eva's family. We're all wishing her well. And this is her second attempt. Nice and comfortable on her opener. Second time, 120 kilos. That's a lovely dip at the end. That takes any doubt out of the judge's mind straight away, doesn't it? Three white lights.
No doubt, no doubt.
I like that technique.
When you think it there, just go like a dip.
Yeah. And now we're getting Nadege Deschamps from Belgium again. She's put 10 kilos on the bar and taken it up to 185. This would put her within 5 kilos of Hirsch from Norway. Suspect the battle here, if anything, is going to be for silver and bronze. The pole looks to have probably taken the competition with her opening lift. But here we go with Deschamps, Belgium lifter, currently in third place, but perhaps with an outside chance of a silver medal. Here we go.
Could be suspect.
Yeah,
2-1.
Yeah. 2-1. Hence the but she gets the lift. And we move to the 84 plus kilo class. And Monika Lovas has added 15 kilos and put the bar up to 190 kilos. Ralph, what do you think of this jump for the other Hungarian? She's jumped 40 kilos from 170 to 210.
Oh, don't know. Don't know. Unless you're wearing a loose suit to start with and then put that tighter one on late. I don't know.
Or maybe just nerves and she wanted to get a safe one. But I think that's as big a percentage jump as I've ever seen at internationally.
For male, it would be a big jump, but for females.
Yeah, and
really
that's a percentage
big.
It's over 20%.
Yeah. Is.
But first of all, here we have Lovas. She's put 15 kilos on. She probably thought she was going to stay ahead by this jump, but if the other lifter makes it. I have my doubts about depth there. Let's see what the referees say.
Yes,
they like it. And now we move to Hirsch from Norway. She's put 7.5 kilos on the bar. She's got 197.5 for her second attempt. She's quite well behind Kasperska in the squat. But interestingly, her opener on the bench press is 30 kilos higher. She's opted to open with a massive 135 kilos. So it looks as if Kasperska's ahead in squat. Hirsch is ahead in bench press, and they're going to have a battle royal in the deadlift. So here's Katrine Hirsch, Norway. Second attempt, 197.5 kilos. See, as well as Viva TV today, we've got local TV shooting some footage of this European Championships in the hometown, Orosava in Hungary. And this is Hirsch's second attempt. And what do the referees say there? They say three white lights. Okay, back to Kotelej from Hungary. She's asked for 210 kilos. Got 170 opener, looked very, very comfortable in fairness. But this is a big, big jump, 40 kilos.
Good news that.
She gets this, it puts her out of sight, I think, in the 84 plus category. Lavash has gone for 205 third, so this for the gold medal. Let's see if she can get it. Cameras from three different organizations trained on her. Two local TV companies plus Viva TV. This is the sort of coverage powerlifting needs to take a step forward on the international stage. Here we go. Oh, this is looking good. This is looking good. She's got it. That's the gold medal in squat right there. What a jump. What a good lift. And the final lift in the second round will be Kasperska from Poland. She's already safe in the gold medal for squat because Hirsch has opted for 202.5 third lift. Kasperska's already got 215. This is to add to her total. Every kilo she can find in the squat is going to be important. Hirsch has a much bigger opening bench. Opening deadlifts are within 10 kilos of each other. And the two Hungarian girls very closely matched in bench and deadlift openers as well. Again, this could develop into a good battle, but this is your gold medalist in the squat. Going for another 10 kilos on the total. Kasperska, Poland, 225 kilos. Oh, no, the balance just wasn't right there, was it? She just didn't look straight enough when she started the lift, and as soon as she went down, the head went forward.
Seems she went down too fast.
Yeah, just seemed to lose control on the way down. So at the end of the second round, well, in the 84s, it's Kasperska on 215 from Hirsch on 197.5. Deschamps third on 185. Now, Deschamps has gone 195 third, so that leaves Hirsch safe in silver medal position. And Nemeth in fourth place. And in the over 84s, Kotelej leading from Lovash, 210 to 190. And here we have Eva Nemeth for her third and final squat. She's gone for 132.5. Nice progression, 110, 120, 132.5. Let's hope she can get this. Yeah, there's that dip again. I think she's got it.
Well done, Eva.
She has
well
indeed.
She's happy.
She's very happy. If she's running with these wraps on, she's happy. And now we move to Deschamps. Deschamps has opted for 195 third lift. There's her friend Boris in the picture again. if anyone is wondering who, well, nobody would worry about Boris. If anybody's wondering who Boris is our technical supremo. He's the one that all the next lift attempts go to, enters all the information in the system, and then passes the information to the speaker. So here we have Nadege Deschamps from Belgium in bronze medal position in the squat. This lift isn't going to change anything in terms of medal positions in the squat, but it's going to put 10K on her total if she's successful. Now, to my mind, in the second lift, she was very marginal in her depth. So
yeah, we thought she was close.
Yeah, yeah, so let's see what happens this time. And here she goes. Well, it's the same lift. I expect the same results. And it is 2-1, same as last time. And once again, she looked delighted with that. And we moved to Hirsch from Norway. She's gone for 2:02.5. And this will take her very, very close to Kasperska, you know, in terms of predicted totals. The prediction has changed to 2.5 kilos between them. I say that's based on nominated openers in bench and deadlift, and but it's often not a bad indication. This is an important lift, not within the squat, but within the overall position. It's a big lift for Hirsch. Kasperska might have gone too heavy second lift, and she might end up paying for that. First Hirsch. She's powered that back up. Coach likes it. Referees like it. 2-1. And we move now to the 84-plus kilo class. Back to the two Hungarians. First up, we got Monika Lobash. She's gone for 205 kilos. So it's another 15-kilo jump route. She's gone 175 to 190 and 190 to 205.
Yeah. This might be very close because the...
Well, Kotelesh is on 210. So if she gets this, she's within 5 kilos of her. Puts a lot of pressure on Kotelesh. Kotelesh has got the goal for the squat, but makes the total battle quite interesting. So she's got to get this, really. I think if she fails this, she's going to be a long way behind going into bench and squats. But if she gets this, she's right in the mix. So let's wish her well.
She comes out nice and steady. Get it set up. Get the feet in the right place.
I think I'd like to see the feet slightly wider, personally. Well, she went up when the coach told her to. I think he might have told her a bit early, but she's got three white lights. What do I know? Good lifts. And that's put her right in the mix. Now she's only 5 kilos behind Kotelesh, who is out next, attempting 220 kilos. After this, we've got Kasperska's third attempt, and we'll have a 20-minute break while the girls warm up for bench press. And here we go. Kotelesh from Hungary, attempting 220 kilos.
Two turn was comfortable enough. So
yes, it was.
Got a chance in this one.
I mean, she's just wearing a singlet as well, isn't she? There's no squat suit, just wraps. No, that's just too heavy. Well, there's only 5 kilos between the two Hungarians after squats. Gold to Kotelesh and silver to Lobash. And look at the way they jumped on their openers in squat. These predictions may mean absolutely nothing. We will see as the afternoon unfolds. We have one more squat in this session, And that is Kasperska from Poland again. She missed 225 last time, lost to balance forward. In terms of the overall competition, she needs this. The prediction now is only 2.5 kilos between her and Hirsch, and that is based on her getting this lift. So this is vital for her in her quest for the European Championship. Kasperska from Poland. Oh, that's a lot better. Oh, that's so much better than the last one. And she's got two whites. And just to summarize the scoreboard in the under 84 kilo class, Deschamps wins the bronze, Hirsch wins the silver, and Kasperska the gold. And in the 84 kilo class, it's silver to Lovash and gold to Cotelege. We will be back. Well, just before we go to a break, we're going to run a bench press video for you just to take you through the basics of the bench press.
The bench press. In the bench press, the lifter lifts the bar from the rack. With their arms straight, the referee gives the command.
Start!
The lifter lowers the bar onto their chest or abdominal area, where the referee will cue the lift.
Press!
The lifter presses the bar until the arms are straight, the elbows are locked, and the bar has stopped moving. On lift completion, the referee will then command.
Rack.
Throughout the lift, the head, shoulders, and buttocks must be in contact with the bench, and the feet must remain flat on the floor. The bar can be returned to the rack with or without the help of the spotters.
Start. Press. Rack.
And we hope you found that informative. We're going to take a quick break now. The clock is ticking at 18 minutes to go before the bench press commences. We'll be back at least 5 minutes before the lifting starts to bring you up to speed with everything. Myself and Ralph will have a little chat about the bench press rules in a little bit more detail. But we'll take a short break and we will see you the other side of it. Bye for now.
Benching back, I don't know what's up. So I rang Jazz a while ago and FaceTime. Please call her and ask her to send me an email.
And welcome back to Orosháza in Hungary, where we're a third of the way through the competition in the women's under 84 and over 84 kilo classes. The girls are just finishing their warm-up for the bench press, and we thought we'd spend a couple of minutes just discussing the rules of the bench press and some of the main reasons for failure. I've got Ralph Farquharson with me once again, and Ralph, once again, we've got three different indicated lights for failure. We've got a red, a blue, and a yellow. Would you like to run us through the main reasons for failure? Give the viewers at home something that they might be able to look for and understand when...
Yep, sure. And the bench press, obviously, I'll just run you through. They have the starting position. You said that when the lifter starts, his arms, elbow must be straight. He must lie flat on the bench. His head, shoulders, buttocks must be flat on the bench. And also the feet must be flat. The feet allowed to move. It can slide along. But however, it's not allowed to lift off the floor or turn over at the side.
And one of the, sorry to interrupt, Ralph, one of the reasons why you see the referee holding the lifter for such a long time in bench press is they won't give them the start signal until everything's in place.
Right. The rules clearly state that the bar must be motionless at the stop, at the start of the chest. So when the bar is lowered to the chest, there must be visible pause at the chest before the referee give a signal to press.
So when we see a red light reason for failure on bench press, what would that normally signify, Ralph?
It would mean that the bar is not lowered to chest, it's not touching the chest, it's touching the belt.
Okay.
It can just the chest or the abdominal area, it's not allowed to touch the belt.
Yeah, there was quite a significant rule change a couple of years ago.
This
wasn't it regarding touching? It used to be that it wasn't allowed below the sternum.
That's right.
But
that's,
now it's anywhere above the belt.
It's difficult, especially the bigger lifter, to decide where the chest end and the sternum start. Yeah. So it's don't change the rule. Don't you
and
say,
a lot of the shirts tend to pull the bar down anyway.
That is true.
So a red light is to do with the bar either not touching the chest at all, or touching too low and touching the belt.
Yeah.
Well, if we see a blue for failure, what would we be looking for there?
A blue is if the bar, downward movement the bar, and this is the whole of the bar.
Yeah.
So the whole of the bar must go back down again before it's a no, it's a blue light.
And also, of course, if the bar isn't fully locked out,
that'll
be a blue as well. So the red is to do with touching the chest.
Yeah.
The blue is to do with the movement of the bar.
Absolutely.
And then we get into the fun of the yellow and bench press, because it could be half a dozen different things, couldn't it?
Eight different for all the yellow.
But the main ones for yellow would be if the buttocks coming off the bench, perhaps.
That's correct. That's
the head moving.
The feet come off
the feet coming off the floor, yeah. Or failing to observe any of the referee signals.
That's
because one of the big issues, perhaps not so much at this standard, but in local competitions and divisions in countries for new lifters, failing to observe the referee's commands. Yeah. They start too soon,
signal.
They don't wait for the press command, or most commonly they get the first two commands. They're so excited to press the bar up that they just stick it back on the rack without waiting for that command. You see that quite often as well.
This is why it's also good in the training that the coach teaches the athletes to learn to start lower, press, and hold at the end, and then rack. So
well,
they get that idea that they must.
I mean, certainly none of the lifters in my training group would ever go to a competition without really being schooled in that. And I think that's one of the ways you can tell the lifter who just trains in the gym and hasn't got any experienced help, because they're the ones more likely to make these mistakes at their first competition. Having said that, I saw a Masters 3 lifter with about 40 years of experience going before the press command at the World Masters a few years ago. And when I asked him why he did it afterwards, he didn't have a bleeping clue.
But sometimes you can
do it. He did.
Go blank. It can be a blank.
Okay, we're back with the bench press now. The clock is ticking down to 20 seconds. We will be starting off in the under 84 kilo class with Eva Nemet, your translator, Ralph. She acquitted herself very well in the squat discipline, got 3 out of 3, finished with a nice 132.5, and she's opening with a 90 kilo bench press.
Yeah, I was talking to her yesterday, and she was ever so nervous. It was,
well, she will be first sleeping. Competition, yes, and probably there'd be something wrong with her if she wasn't.
Absolutely.
You know, first international competition on home soil, you know, against much more experienced lifters. But she's done herself proud so far, and I'm sure she'll continue to do so as the day goes on. So here we have Eva Nemeth from Hungary opening the bench press competition with an attempt at 90 kilos. It's good down and good up. Can't see anything wrong with that. Neither can the referees. Good lifts. And now we move on to Kasperska from Poland. Kamila Kasperska. She's got a bench press PB of 100. She's opening a 105. I hope this isn't risky. The gold medalist from the squat. But she's opening 30 kilos below the Norwegian. I'm just hoping the Norwegian hasn't pressurized her into a higher opener than she should really be attempting. So this is Kamila Kasperska from Poland, going for a lifetime personal best on her opening bench press. Here she goes. Let's see how this looks.
I think she stopped.
I don't think she.
No, she got all blue.
That's just what we're talking about, Ralph. Downward movements. Yeah, all three referees saw downward movement there. Now, this can be really, really interesting because, you know, she's opening 5 kilos above her personal best. You got to ask why.
Very dangerous. Like you said, she may have been pressurized by.
She probably thought she couldn't give away any more than 30 kilos to the Norwegian. But moving into the 84 plus category, this is Monica Lovash, silver medalist in the squat, opening her bench press with 120 kilos. That looks good. Oh, yeah, very easy.
Perfect.
And we stay in the 120-plus kilo class. No, sorry, we move to the under 84 kilo class. This is Nadege Deschamps from Belgium. She's opening 122.5. Now, we've got her PB as 140 kilos. So she's going to the other extreme from Kasperska. This is very conservative.
It's probably the right way to do it.
Yeah.
Four in a category, so looking for a medal. Yeah.
It's going to be interesting seeing Kasperska's second bench press. I think that's going to tell us a lot. But first, Deschamps. And then Kotiles, the Hungarian, to follow. Struggling to touch. Oh, that looks very near her limit as well.
I think she gets
it. She gets it. Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah, it was there. I just don't know if there's another 20 kilos.
No.
That was very close to her limit, it looked. Okay, we've got Kotiles from Hungary now. 127.5 kilos. The gold medalist in the squat. Have you seen what Lovash has put in the bar for her second bench press, Ralph? She's up to 27.5 kilos. She's going 147.5, and the prognosis has changed. You know, we said maybe don't read too much into these Hungarian openers. I think we've got it just right.
A loose shirt on? I don't know.
Well, I don't know, but I mean, she absolutely blasted that opener.
Yes,
maybe she's just going to ramp the shirt down a bit. But this is Kotiles. 127.5 kilos. I think we just got to forget the prognosis and just see how the competition unfolds. Here we go. Oh, did you see an easier bench press ever at an international competition? That was heavy. I know lots of guys that can't get close to that. She made it look like it was an empty bar. And now we got Hirsch from Norway. Final lifter of the first round. Now, with Kasperska missing her opener and taking the same weight again, this is going to put Hirsch in a very, very good place if she gets this. I do hope I'm pronouncing the name correctly, but I'm copying the speaker. I've only got it wrong if he's got it wrong. It's normally the big names that I have trouble with, not the four-letter ones. But this is Katrin Hirsch. I did okay with the Icelandic one yesterday. I was quite chuffed with myself for that. Here we go. Here we go. This is an important lift. Struggling to get it down. Bang! Up it goes.
That's a good one.
Well, well, this competition. She's got it. She got one for maybe it was bum, maybe it was head, maybe it was feet. She got one yellow from the, I'm guessing probably center referee. It may have been head. I wasn't looking for that, I must confess. But she's got it 2-1. We go to the scoreboard in the 84s. Hirsch leads from Deschamps and Nemeth with Kasperska still to get on the board. And Kotelesh leads Lovash by 7.5 kilos. Wow, Ralph, have you seen what Kotelesh has gone second? She's jumped from 127.5 to 165. She's increased it by 37.5 kilos. Well, she did the same in her squat, didn't she?
That's close to the European record, I think.
Is it?
Let's have a look. 182.5.
Well, if she's, you know, this is mad. This is fun. And this is Eva Nemeth. Second attempt. She's gone up 15 kilos, 105. Come on, Eva. I think so, yes. I think so. Three white lights. Well done. Now, we've got Kasperska again. 105. Nemeth's made that. Kasperska, second attempt. She really, really needs to get this. If she doesn't get this, she's under enormous pressure next time round. And we did think it was slightly ambitious. You know, she's got a declared PB of 100 kilos going 105. You know, we say time and time again, get your first one in, get your first one in. You've got two more to do what you need to do. Here we go, Kasperska, second attempt. Faster off the chest, fight it through harder. That's better, that's better. Yeah. Yes, good lift.
Adjustment was made to
the shirt. Oh, no, it's not, Ralph.
No?
She's got a yellow and a blue. Well, I don't know what the blue was for. I certainly didn't see any doubt. The Polish coach is going to the jury.
And the jury is shaking their hands and say, I don't know.
The jury are saying they're agreeing with the referees. Yeah.
Now it stands. Yeah.
So, well, she's got one more attempt or she's gone.
I don't know. Did you not stop? You got blue light.
She got a blue and a yellow. I'm guessing the yellow would have been the head from the center referee, but the blue must be downward movement. She locked the bar. The blue's downward movement or not locking out, and she certainly locked it out. Well, the chest would be red. You know, it's got to be downward movement. And I didn't see that. But as we said before, the referee's better placed than us. This is Deschamps. This is Deschamps, 130. And that looks good. Or did the spotters? Oh, no, the spotters took that. Yeah. So, sorry, we almost missed it, Sean, with all the chat about Kasperska. But now we got Hirsch. Her second attempt, 140 kilos. the two Hungarians to follow. One has jumped 27 and a half kilos, and the other has jumped 37 and a half. This lift will put Hirsch in a very, very good place. Oh, we don't have favorites, Ralph, but we don't want to see anyone go out.
No. Not at this level, at any level.
No. Here she goes. Gets the touch.
No.
Well, she was very close to her limit on her opener then, wasn't she? Now, the first of the two Hungarians, Monika Lovas. She's jumping from 120 to 147.5. They both made it look really easy last time, so I'm not surprised at the big increases. But in percentage terms, what Kotelesh is doing, I've never seen anything like this in an international competition before. Maybe she was listening to the live stream and us saying, get the first one in, get the first one in. And in a two-horse race, you don't want to beat yourself.
Absolutely.
So here is Lovas, going for 147.5 kilos, over 325 pounds. I think she's going to get this. No.
Yeah, stay still.
Well, will she get get reds or no, three whites?
Yep.
Bit of a problem touching.
Yeah, she was struggling to get
that isn't a reason for failure. It just looks messy sometimes, doesn't it? But it's not a reason for failure. And now we've got the other Hungarian. What an increase she's put on. She's gone from 127.5 to 165 kilos. This is Maria Kotelesz. Now, her PB is 170. So the 165 should be there. Probably just nerves with the wanting to get a safe opener in. But I have never seen such an easy bench press at international level than her first one. So let's wish her well. What did you say the European record was, Ralph?
I think she's getting
is she anywhere close to it?
Yeah,
182, did you say?
182.5, yeah.
Well, let's see if this flies and... Here we go. Last lift of the second round. Whoa, no bother at all. Three white lights. Well. Be interesting to see what goes on the bar. Quick look at the scoreboard, first of all. At the end of the second round, in the lead is still Hirsch. Deschamps, the Belgium second. Your translator Nemitz in the bronze medal position,
yes,
Ralph, and Kasperska. Well, she's got to get this or she's out. And she's next up. And in the battle between the two Hungarians in the 84+, Kotelesz 165, leading Lovas on 147.5. She's not gone for the record in the third lift, but she is going for a PB, Kotelesz. But first of all, this is the important lift.
Yeah,
this is Kamila Kasperska from Poland. She must make this lift to stay in the competition. Not only to stay in the competition, but she's the favorite for gold. This has to be good. Here she Oh, that's good.
That should be good.
That should be good. Oh, yeah. Well done. What a brave young lady getting it on the third lift. She continues in the competition. What a sigh of relief. And now we come to Nemeth, the Hungarian lifter. And this will be to take the bronze medal, Ralph. Kasperska's gone into bronze medal position on body weight, but she's got no more lifts left. And if Eva gets this, she walks away with a bronze medal. Wouldn't that
Come
be fantastic?
On, Eva. Let's go for it, girl. She'd be so excited.
Here we go. She's only got it. Let's see what they... Oh, she's got it! 2-1! She would never have expected that in 100 years. That's a bronze medal for Eva Nemeth from Hungary in the bench press. I think that's the happiest lifter I've seen all week. Well done to her. Now we got Deschamps coming out again. She missed 130. She's upped it to 135. And she is... Well, she's safe in second. She's second place on body weight. That's not going to change because 135 matches hers. You think she might have gone 137 if she was going to do it. But having said that, she failed 130. This might be too ambitious by itself. Oh, she's fighting. Oh, no, it's gone down. You know, that was one brave attempt. But Deschamps gets the silver medal. Now, Hirsch, gold medalist in bench. She missed 140 last time. She's having another attempt at it. And then we've got the two big Hungarians. Then we're into a 20-minute break again. Ralph, we're getting questions over the internet about the role of the jury. So perhaps before we go to the break after this session, we can spend a couple of minutes discussing that and just bringing people up to date with what they do. First of all, this is Hirsch, the Norwegian lifter. The prognosis is putting her in gold medal position by 2.5 kilos. If she gets this, vital. Vital. And she's fighting it. You know what? She's locked it. She's locked it. See what they say. Oh, two yellows. I would imagine that's buttocks off the bench with the effort.
Sure.
So now for the two Hungarians. First of all, Lovash, 152.5 kilos. Well, we said it wasn't a big field, but we were going to have quality battles, and we weren't wrong. Only six girls, but we've seen some fantastic lifting and a lot of drama. And this is going to go right through to the final deadlift. So this is Monica Lovash. Attempting 152.5 kilos. How many men do you know, Ralph, that can bench press 152.5?
Not many.
Not that many. It's a big, big weight. Nearly 340 pounds in old money. About 24 stone, just to give you an idea. And she's only got it. Three wide. And you know what? It was the beginning that looked difficult. I mean, what should happen with the short is the beginning's easy and then they struggle. She struggled and then that must be one strong pair of triceps and that young lady right there. And now we've got Kotelej. Final bench press of the session, 175 kilos. Just going through the scoreboard before she comes out so we can get on to the jury discussion. Winner of the bench presses in the 84 plus is this young lady, Kotelej. She's leading with 165. This will increase her lead if she gets it. Excellent runner-up place for Lovash with 152.5. And Hirsch getting the gold in the under 84s from Deschamps and Kaspersk. And Nemeth getting a fantastic bronze medal. But the focus is on Kotelej. Final bench press. 175 kilos, not far off 400 pounds on the bar. Here we go. You know what? That was easy. What a fantastic series of bench presses.
It's a pretty damn 40 steps don't allow anymore.
What a fantastic series of bench presses. And just to summarize, gold medal in the under 84s to Hirsch, silver to Deschamps, and a fantastic bronze for Nemeth, gold for Kotelesh, silver for Lovash in the 84 plus category. Now, Ralph, before we go to break, we've had questions posted on the internet about the role of the jury. They sit there, and to a lot of people, they don't seem to do an awful lot. I know you're a regular member of the jury. Could you spend a minute or so just taking us through what the jury's there for and what it does?
First and foremost, there must be three international category one. In other words, they must be wearing a red tie. They're not allowed to be on the jury if you're category two.
And so, category two don't wear a red tie, then what do
they wear? A blue tie.
They wear a blue tie.
If you wear a blue tie, you're category two. And the jury is there to oversee the rule, to make sure the technical rule is carried out by the referees in the chair. Okay, that's the first thing. Okay. They're not, on very, very rare occasion, they will overrule the referees. What they will do, if the referee continue to give, in their opinion, a wrong decision, they will warn them once, they warn them twice, and if they do it three times, they can remove them from the chair.
Okay, so the referees are really under a lot of pressure from jury there.
Yes, they are being scrutinized. And they will tell them, okay, that something's wrong, please pay attention. If you're not doing that, then they can give a lift to another attempt if the referee makes a very, very bad mistake. For instance, if the referee forgets to give the lifter a start signal.
Yes.
Yeah, things like those, then we can say, okay, we'll give the lifter another attempt at the end of the round.
I mean, would they be tempted to overrule a referee, say, who passed a high squat?
Not really, no, because the referees and the chairs in a better position than the jury are. We can say, look, in our opinion, we think that was a high squat, and please pay attention.
Yes. And then you're into the first warning, second warning,
absolutely,
and so on. Now,
absolutely.
The other thing is, I see when coaches are unhappy with a decision, they're not allowed to approach the referee, are they? It must be the jury that they go to.
That's correct. You will see the coaches will run across to the jury table, and they put their complaint to the jury, and then the jury must be in total agreement to give them another attempt. Okay? If it's 2-1, if two juries said yes, one said no, it can't happen. It must be all three jury must say yes, I agree, that is a mistake made, then they will give another attempt at the end of the round.
So what sort of things are the coaches most likely to approach the jury table to protest about?
In the squat, normally depth.
Okay.
Yeah, because, and again, like I said, the jury do not intend to overrule the referees. But most times.
Would there be an occasion where a coach would complain because another lifter has been given a lift that he thought they shouldn't have been given? Does that happen?
They can complain, but that normally you're supposed to put a fee down. I think, I don't know how much it's in euro, if you want to put a complaint in, but then we'll go to the jury.
Any jury approach can be quite costly in financial terms.
Otherwise, you could spend time wasting your jury time, stopping the competition, complaining. Yes. So they said you must pay a fee to, and then they will decide whether or not.
So it's not like tennis where you got one or two challenges per set, and then you got to pay for anything else. You pay for every single one.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks very much for that, Ralph. We hope that was quite educational and has given you more insight into the role of the jury. We'll take a quick break now from Oroshaza in Hungary. The clock is ticking down to 16 minutes. We'll be back with you just before the deadlift to take you through the final phase of this competition. It's sure to prove very, very exciting. We've seen already that openers mean absolutely nothing, and it's going to be fascinating to see how things work out. Kasperska and Hirsch, very, very close in the under 84s. And the two Hungarians in the over 84s, well, the openers mean absolutely nothing. And who knows where that's going to finish. So we'll take a break for 10 minutes or so, and we'll be back with you in time for the deadlift competition. Bye for now. and welcome back to the European Junior and Sub-Junior Championships here in Orosasa in Hungary. We were talking about the jury just before we went away to the break, and we've just got a picture of the jury, totally oblivious to the fact that they've been streamed worldwide as we speak. From left to right, you are seeing Jean-Claude Verdonk from Belgium, Werner Hafner from Germany, and Imre Mustafa from Hungary. And the clock is ticking down to 20 seconds, just about to start the deadlift competition. This promises to be one great competition. I'm going to love to see what these two Hungarians lift in the 84s, Ralph, and in the under 84 kilo class. Well, Hoche and Kasperska are predicted to be within 2.5 kilos of each other.
It's going to be down to that bar on the floor
again. It's going to be close. So, first up is your translator, Ralph. Amen, name it. I think the happiest person in this building after the bronze medal. She's here for experience, and because of Kasperska's problems with the bench press, she comes away with a fantastic bronze medal with her third bench press. So here she goes, one on the board, and she makes a total. 110 kilos. Yes, that's a sensible, easy opener. Three white lights, she makes a total. Well done, Eva. Next lifter up is Deschamps. The bar goes from 110 kilos to 150 kilos. Now, Deschamps has a PB of 187.5, so there should be a bit in reserve, but she didn't get near her stated PB in the bench.
No, she didn't.
You know, I'm just wondering perhaps if those PBs were set at a higher weight class, and she may have come down a weight class and...
She's just having a bad build up to the European, maybe.
But then she's opening so far below the PBs that, we'll maybe find that out later on and let you know. But anyway, this is Nadege Deschamps from Belgium. Attempting her first deadlift of 150 kilos. Say, we may see a big jump second lift. She's comfortably ahead of Nemet, so... it may be a case of get one easy one in, get the bronze medal secure, and go on from there. Yes, that looked easy. Three white lights. And now we move into the over 84 kilo class. And the next one up will be Monika Lovas, the lighter of the two Hungarians in this class. And she's also opening with 150 kilos. Following her will be Kotelej, the other Hungarian, opening 15 kilos heavier on 165. First of all, here's Lovas. To make a total, remember, every time a lifter gets their opening deadlift, they've made a total. And that's the first priority in the competition. If you don't make a total, you can't get a medal. Here we go. Well, how easy did that look?
That looks comfortable.
Three white lights.
I think it could be a big jump here for a second.
Yes, I expect. What do you reckon? 175, maybe 170, 175. And now the other Hungarian, Kotelej, is coming out. Maria Kotelej, 23-year-old student in her last year as a junior. Well, she'll be finishing her junior career with a European gold medal if she makes this lift. This gets her a total. Yeah, Lovas has gone 170 second lift. We're getting quite good at this, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. My expert.
Even with Hungarians who set out to deceive and confuse us. But this is Kotelej. This is 165 kilos. Let's see what she makes of this. Well, that didn't look too difficult.
At all.
And put down as if she was in a library. Wouldn't it be nice to see more of that? And we move back to the big two in the under 84 kilo class. First of all, Hirsch, the Norwegian. Now, the predictions are that if she and Kasperska both make their openers, Kasperska's ahead by 2.5 kilos. This is going to go right down to the last deadlift.
Right down to the wire.
And it may be tactics as much as strength that gets the gold medal here. But first out, Hirsch. Let's see what she makes of 175. Is it going to be a struggle? Is it going to fly up? How much more is in the tank? This is the battle for gold starting right here. Oh, yes, that was nice and easy.
Good start.
Okay, Kasperska, 10 kilos more. She's going for 185. This will give her 515. Hirsch sitting on 512.5.
Who's the lighter?
The lighter one is Kasperska by 400 grams. They're both miles under the limit. 84 kilo limit, 74.4, yeah. Kasperska, 78.4 Kasperska, 78.8 Hirsch. But here goes Kasperska. Now let's see how easy this looks. Or not, as the case may be. Here she goes. Polish lifter to go into gold medal position. Now, that is a good lift.
Good lift, but it wasn't that strong.
Did she let go? Well, she's got
okay.
it.
She was okay.
Now, based upon that, we'll go to the scoreboard, Ralph. Based upon that, in the under 84s, Kasperska leads from Hirsch, Deschamps in third, and Kotelesh leading from Lovash in the over 84s. Now, there's 2.5 kilos between them, but I think Hirsch has a lot more in the tank base than those first rounders than Kasperska has. But good thing is they've all got a deadlift in. They've all made a total. But these second one now. Hirsch has gone 185 second. I think she's going to make that. Let's see what Kasperska goes. She's got to stay
192.
Well,
she's pushing for the lead.
Well, that'll be tied, and Kasperska will be heading body weight. So if they both make them, that's a good lift from Ava. If Kasperska and Hirsch both make their seconds, they're going to be absolutely tied on 522.5 with one lift to go, and only 400 grams separating them, but it's in Kasperska's favor. Before all that, Nadege Deschamps, the Belgian lifter, she is going for 165. She's got a PB of 187.5. So we think she's either lifting very conservatively today, or perhaps she set these PBs at a higher weight class. Only 18 years of age in her first year as a full junior. Plenty of time to develop as a lifter. Lifting these sorts of weights at this sort of age augurs very well for the future. Here she goes. Second attempt, 165. Well, yeah. Look, that's the good. That's good.
Top half a bit tight.
Yeah, it looked good. A wee bit of a struggle to lock it out, but powerful off the floor. Of course, the sumo has that effect, doesn't it, Ralph?
Yes.
The wide stance, easier to get off the floor, but perhaps
slow
a little bit more
end.
Difficult to lock out, as opposed to the conventional, where perhaps the first bit is more difficult, but the lockout is easier.
Because the conventional, once you get to your knees, the idea is to push the hip forward.
Push the hips forward, but when you're wider stance, that's more difficult.
Difficult to do, yeah.
Yeah. So, back to the 84s. This is Lovash. She's opted for 170 kilos. Kotelesh opted for 175. So, could be a big battle in third lifts for gold medal between the two Hungarians, because Lovash is the lighter body weight. Let's see how these lifts look. Lovash first. Kotelesh to follow. That's good. She struggled to get it moving a bit, but once she did, plenty of power. Just needs to work on maybe that dynamic drive off the floor a little bit more. And now we've got Kotelesh going for 175. Now, Lovash is in the lead after that lift. She's overtaken. Kotelesh is opening 165. So Cortelesh needs this to go back into the gold medal position. I can't see her missing it based on the 165. Commentator's curse again, maybe. But here is Maria Cortelesh battling with her fellow Hungarian for gold in deadlift and overall gold as well. Here we go, 175 kilos. Oh, that didn't even look difficult, did it?
Not at all.
Three white lights. Where can this girl finish? Well, she can't go too mad because Lovash has gone 183rd. She's got to be... Mind you, she could always change if Lovash gets it.
Got two changes,
yeah,
so.
She's got two changes. Why not use... Okay. We've got Hirsch and Kasperska coming out now. Now, this from Hirsch is to retake the lead in the overall battle. Kasperska ahead in deadlifts. This is a big lift. This puts pressure on Kasperska. If she gets it, takes the pressure off if she doesn't. She looked at plenty in the tank after the first one. This is...
That's gone for double. Get hip through. Did it finish?
Yes, it did. Well, now, we thought Kasperska was quite close to her limit. If you want me to call this, I think Kasperska will get this. Won't get her third.
Yep.
And I think Hirsch is a little bit more in the tank. If I had to put money on this, it would be Hirsch to get it on the last lift.
She's for a favorite for the goal at the moment.
Yeah.
But we never know. Never know.
It's good to speculate. And here comes Kasperska. That lift from Hirsch has put all the pressure back on this girl. She's shown in bench press she can handle pressure. She's got to face it all over again here. This is to go back into the lead, but only on body weight. Here we go, Kamila Kasperska, Polish lifter.
Tighten hips. Big drive.
We thought she was near her limit, Ralph, the first time. We called that just right. Let's go to the scoreboard. And we can see on the scoreboard that Kasperska still leads in the deadlifts, only in body weight from Hirsch, with Deschamps in third. And the two Hungarian lifters in the over 84s, only 5 kilos separates them. But in the overall standings, Hirsch is now 10 kilos. No, Hirsch is 7.5 kilos ahead of Kasperska. Kasperska's gone 192 and a half again.
Yeah.
Hirsch has gone 192 and a half as well.
Okay.
She's lot one, so she can't change.
No.
I mean, if I was Hirsch, I might be going 187 and a half and just challenging Kasperska to do what she clearly couldn't do last time. But Nemeth first. Her last lift of the day to finish off an excellent afternoon's lifting. And she gets it. 3 out of 3, 9 out of 9. Great series for Eva Nemeth. And now Deschamps.
We'll probably get over here for a little chat later, maybe.
Yes. Be nice if we could actually start chatting to a few lifters afterwards. I think perhaps as the way we cover the competition develops, we can start having a word with lifters maybe after the medal ceremonies, getting some comments on them. I mean, we're telling the audience how the lifter might be thinking, but their thinking might be completely different from what we're imagining, so it'd be very good to get the lifter inside. But here we go with Deschamps. 5 more lifts to go this morning. And we're back at 5 o'clock, of course, with the junior men's 93 kilo class and 105 kilo class. That should be a fantastic evening's lifting. We've got 7 lifters in
some
the
big numbers in there.
In the 93, yeah. 6 lifters in the 105s.
Please make a
it
note.
Should be fantastic. So 5 o'clock Hungarian time, we'll be back for these two classes. Please join us then. But this is Nadege Deschamps from Belgium. tempting. She's done brilliantly today as well, looking for a 170.
Did
that rest on the thighs, or has she got it?
Yes.
She's got it. And that's a bronze medal in the total and a bronze medal in the deadlift for Nadege Deschamps. Now we come to the battle between the two Hungarians. Lovash going for one. Oh, it's a change. It's a change. Lovash is up to 182.5. which means that Kotelej is out first, and she's the heavier body weight. Now, is Kotelej going to change as well?
No, I think she's maybe waiting to see what she missed it. She
might if I was Kotelej, I'd be going, oh, yes, she has.
Yes.
She has. Kotelej has done what I would have done if I was Kotelej. And it's back to Lovash. Is she going to change again?
Can't see anyone coming. Now she's ready to go.
Now she's ready to go. This is to go into the gold medal position in the deadlift with one lift to go. Very impressed with both these Hungarians, Ralph.
Yes. Some really good young lifters coming through from Hungary.
And really strong as well. I mean, I know there's only two of them, but this is real competitive weights that they're moving here. They're not token weights at all. Here we go, Lovash, over 400 pounds on the bar. Can she get it moving? We know she can lock it. Yes, she can.
She's fighting.
She's fighting. She's fighting, and she's got it.
Is the knee locked?
Whoa, good call.
No, the knee was just locked.
She leaned back, but didn't quite get the knees locked out. Well. Now, Kotelej can go back down to 182.5 if she wants, but I guess she'll probably just leave it to 185. She's won the deadlift gold. She's won the overall gold based on her 175. I don't want to put the commentator's skirt on her. I can't see her not getting this. She's got to fight. She's got to have the fire one last time. Gold medals in all three individual disciplines and total gold European champion. Last lift of the day, Maria Kotelej from Hungary, attempting 185 kilos. Very good Hungarian in this weight class, and the sub juniors as well from day one.
From day one, yeah.
Oh, she's got that, and there was more if she needed it. Good lift, and great lifting from Maria Kotelej, and we now have two lifters remaining. Hirsch has taken it back to 187.5, and she's going first. I think this is probably quite sensible. She's saying, I'm going to do this.
I'm putting the board.
I don't think you can do yours. Yeah. So the gold medal and deadlift is going to be decided in the next two lifts, but so is the gold medal in total. This is Katrin Hirsch. She must get this. If she doesn't, she loses on body weight. If she does, she puts Kasperska under huge pressure. Here we go. I think she's got this. She had the last one. She's only 2.5K heavier. Here she goes. It's going. It's going. Has she locked it? She's got the down signal. She's got it. That's put her in the lead with one lift to go. Now, Kasperska's had to go up 195. She failed 192. She didn't really get close to it. She's got to come in with a totally different mental attitude this time. She's got to come in here psyched up and rip this bar off
the
floor.
Final lift of day.
This is for the gold medal. This decides whether the gold medal goes to Norway or Poland. Don't think we've heard the Polish national anthem this week yet, have we?
Not so far.
That could all change. Well, I wish Kasperska well. I think the Norwegians got it.
Yeah, I think so too.
Let's see if she can prove me wrong. How does she look? Does she look ready for this?
She needs to get everything tight.
Absolutely. Everything right. Bar close to the body. Fight, fight, fight.
Every fiber into play.
This is the big lift of the day. This is for gold. This is to be the European champion. And we called it right, Ralph. Yes, we called it right. Yes. Just too much. Brave attempt. Hirsch is the European champion. If we look at the scoreboard in total, Hirsch finishes with 525 kilos. Kasperska, silver medal, 515. The bronze to Deschamps with 487.5. And a very, very creditable 375 for Eva Nemat, which includes a surprise bronze medal in the bench press. And in the over 84 kilo category, Kotelesh, biggest total of the day, 570 kilos, beating her fellow Hungarian Lovash, who had the second highest total of the day, 527.5, into the silver medal position. That was a small field, but by gosh, that was some exciting and impressive lifting there. Yeah. We'll take a short break and we'll be back with you for the medal ceremonies. And welcome back to the award ceremony for the under 84 and over 84 competitions that you've just been watching. We are currently seeing Jiří Hoferek from the Czech Republic and Andreas Ronoseki, the president of the Hungarian Powerlifting Federation, congratulating each of the lifters for their efforts before the presentation of medals. First, we will have the under 84 kilo class and the awards for the squat. The bronze medal goes to Nadège Deschamps from Belgium with a squat of 185 kilos. The silver medal goes to Katrine Hirsch from Norway with a squat of 202.5 kilos. And the gold medal goes to Kamila Kasperska from Poland with a squat of 225 kilos. And we move on to the awards for bench press. The bronze medal, possibly the most surprising and the most popular medal of the day, goes to Eva Nemeth from Hungary. The silver medal goes to Nadège Deschamps from Belgium with a bench press of 122.5 kilos. And the gold medal goes to Katrine Hirsch from Norway with a bench press of 135 kilos. And we move on to the awards for the deadlifts. Bronze medal with a lift of 170 kilos, Nadège Deschamps from Belgium. The silver medal goes to Kamila Kasperska from Poland with a lift of 185 kilos. The gold medal, Katrine Hirsch from Norway, 187.5 kilos. And moving on to the overall awards and the crowning of the European champion, the bronze medalist from Belgium, Nadège Deschamps, with a total of 487.5 kilos. The silver medal goes to Kamila Kasperska from Poland with a total of 515 kilos. Just couldn't get that last deadlift she needed to move from silver to gold. But a great competition between her and the European champion for 2015, Katrine Hirsch from Norway, with a total of 525 kilos. And we are now going to hear the national anthem of Norway. Thank you. And Hirsch fights to keep the tears away and finishes with a lovely smile as she celebrates her victory after a fantastic battle with Kasperska from Poland. Both girls should be very proud of themselves. A fantastic battle that went right down to the last deadlift of the competition. Lovash. And the gold medal goes to Maria Kotelesz from Hungary with a squat of 210 kilos. And I don't think they need to go too far away because we now come to the medal ceremony for bench press. And once again, Lovash gets the silver medal with a lift of 152.5 kilos. And the gold medal goes to Kotelesz once again with a fantastic bench press of 175 kilos. And there was more there. There was probably a 400-pound bench press, 182 and a half there, if she needed it. So fantastic performances from both the girls. And we move on to the deadlift awards. I think they're just deciding to remain where they are. The silver goes to Lovash with a lift of 170 kilos. And the gold medal goes to Maria Kotelesz with a deadlift of 185 kilos. And we move to the total awards and the crowning of the European champion for 2015. Silver medal goes to Monika Lovash from Hungary with a total of 527.5 kilos. And the European champion for 2015 from Hungary, Maria Kotelesz, with a total of 570 kilos. And we're now going to hear the Hungarian national anthem as two delighted young ladies stand proudly on the platform listening to their national anthem. And just to put the performances into context, in case anyone is thinking the competition is devalued by only having two lifters, both these lifters finished with a higher total than the winner of the weight class below. So these were genuine European class performances by two high class lifters, and they deserve their moment on the podium. And what can this girl do when she's got a challenge? That's Hungarian wins in the women's over 84 kilo class at both sub-junior and junior. Hungarian lifting has a very bright future. And that ends the afternoon session here at Orosháza in Hungary. Hope you agree it's been a fantastically exciting session. Just before we go, a word of thanks once again to our sponsors, without whom championships like this simply couldn't happen. Our sponsors are SBD Apparel, Elico, Leoco, and ER Equipment. We'll be back again at 5 o'clock. But before we go, I've got a very, very happy young lady with me at the moment. I've got Eva Nemeth from Hungary with me. Eva got a very, very unexpected bronze medal in the bench press. Eva, congratulations. How do you feel?
Much. I am very happy and excited. And I don't know what I said.
Sorry, I just said...
Sorry, we're just giving Eva the headphones. Would you like to start again, Eva? Congratulations on your win.
Thank you so much.
Did you enjoy the whole experience of the competition?
Yes, I really enjoy all the competition and I'm really excited.
Was this your first international competition?
Yes, that's my first national competition.
And how does it compare to competitions you've done before?
Maybe the Hungarian Championship, I'm the best.
Yes.
And I'm very happy. Stay this competition and very happy this medal.
Yeah, were you nervous coming into the competition or?
Really
nervous.
Yes, that's my first national competition and oh my god, what that, oh my god.
But you got all your opening lifts in and then you were able to move on from that.
Yes, I'm very happy and I hope maybe better than this competition.
Each time you will improve on the time before. And you've got a bronze medal from the European Championships.
Yeah, I'm really happy.
Congratulations
once again.
Thank you very much for coming over to speak to us. And we hope to see you at future championships, getting that total higher and higher and higher.
I'm very happy and thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Eva Nemeth, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you so much.
And with that, we will say goodbye. And we will be back with you shortly before 5 o'clock, where we will be featuring the junior men 93 and 105 kilo classes. Until then, from Orosháza in Hungary, goodbye.